How to help children cope with death. Everyone feels sad when someone they love dies. Nobody is ever ready for death, but everyone and everything dies eventually. So it's very important that you talk to your child about death so that when it happens, it isn't a total shock to them. Encourage your child to talk about their favourite memories. Your child may like to draw a picture of the person who has passed away. Talk about how they feel and make sure that you get them to express those feelings. There are ways to help a grieving child. Think about allowing your child to attend the funeral, but only if they want to. Talk about your spiritual beliefs if you have any. For example, you could pray with your child. Some people like to name a star after the person who has deceased, or perhaps plant a tree as a special memorial for that person. Keep your child's daily routine as normal as possible and pay attention to how your child is playing. Play can be one of the child's primary ways of communicating their feelings. There are certain things that you shouldn't do. Don't force your child to go to the funeral if they don't want to. Now, some people tell their children white lies or misleading information. For example, Pop is sleeping now. And this type of information only confuses the child because they will expect that Pop will wake up eventually. So make sure that you tell the truth. Don't tell your child to stop crying. This is part of the grieving process. Also, don't hide your tears. They need to know that it is okay to cry and express their feelings. And don't use your child as a confidant. Talk to a friend or a grown-up family member instead. There are 5 stages of grief. Now, most people go through all 5 stages, but some people don't. And some people will have waves of grief that will continue on for years. But these are the basic stages. The first stage is shock. Now, shock may occur in an unexpected death. Your child may find it difficult to believe that someone has died. During this stage, they may have trouble expressing their feelings and they may not be able to talk about it. Fairly soon after, children go through denial. Your child may refuse to believe that someone has died. They may complain that it's not fair and question why this should happen to their loved one. Anger may be the next emotion that your child will experience. The anger can be directed at a variety of sources, for example, God, maybe the police, another person, doctors, themselves for not stopping it, and sometimes they can even be angry at the person who has died. Sadness comes next. Now, crying is a natural way to express sadness. Allow your child to cry. Don't tell them to be tough. Be there for them, cuddle them, and let them know how much you love them. Acceptance is the final stage of grief. This comes when your child accepts that someone has gone, but they may still feel sad occasionally. Support your child as they move through the stages of grief. Mourning is important because it will help them to express their feelings of anger, confusion, and sadness, heal and eventually get back to normal, and it helps them to say goodbye. How can you prepare your child for the death of a family member or a friend? Well, your child's first experiences of death may be on the television, in a movie, or in a story. Use these opportunities to discuss death with your child. Family pets don't usually live as long as humans. Your child may experience grief when a pet dies. Give the pet a special burial and let your child go through the stages of grief. Talk about special memories. If someone or something dies and your child is upset, make sure you quietly let their teacher know. Your child's teacher can be supportive and will have a greater understanding of the child's moods and feelings. This has been brought to you by Karen Campbell and Katrina Carla from howtohelpchildren.com.